Hey, this is Mike Lindsay from Vital MX, and you know, usually when I do these kind of product videos, I have somebody from marketing or development guy. Now, we dragged the CEO of the company all the way from Australia. Brett, thanks for coming out. You guys
thanks for the opportunity.
Yeah, you guys have a brand new brace here, so I've personally gotten a ride in a range of your guys' product, your previous generation of pod, the K4, which was actually more of the mid to entry level version, is actually the first product we ever gave a 5-star review to. We were talking about that a lot today because it's, I think a lot of it comes down to really what your brace is, not just a motocross knee brace. It's a knee protection brace for a huge range of sports and what guys are looking to do. So can you kick us off there, really?
That's
why
correct.
This differs so much?
The nice thing about the Pod K8 brace, so the K8 is the premium pre-composite, so it's the stiffest, lightest brace we make. Certainly the K4 offers very similar protection. It's got a fiberglass nylon, so still a composite construction, just not as rigid, not quite as stiff and light. But you're 100% correct with the multi-sport adaptability. There's no tools required to convert this brace from a moto impact protective and ligament protective brace into taking and losing the impact protection. You can use it for snow sports, water sports, at the CrossFit gym, whatever you need to give your knees some integrity. So it's more than just a motocross product. You can use it for any recreation that you're looking for knee protection, knee support.
Yeah, so I mean the main key of that from, we won't take it apart here, but it's as simple as there's a right here at the base of each of these plastic cup areas, there's a simple screw you can remove this. So it looks more like what people are probably used to seeing, a medical style knee brace. And that is
correct,
partially because you guys are a certified medical knee brace. Somebody can actually go out and get a doctor to cover this.
That's true. We're actually the only, ourselves and CTI are the only companies that have a billing code. So it's on the backside of the brace. We did have to become medically compliant. All the materials that we actually select need to be able to be used against the skin for 24 hours. In the instance that you did have an operation, had a fresh incision. But yeah, you're 100% correct. You can actually go to your doctor, get a prescription, and with this billing code, they can bill back through your insurance. So you can also buy them at your local motorcycle dealer or certainly online at a motorcycle dealer and submit that receipt with a doctor's prescription back with your medical billing or insurance company.
That is, of course, the entire internal liner of this brace is so much different material than what I'm used to seeing because of the way it has to contact the skin,
right,
and what it has to pass.
Yeah, we used a close-cell EVA foam, and one of the things with moto bracing, as we all know, I mean, you go back to your gear bag after a couple of days and the odor is terrible. So there's no material lining this EVA foam anymore. It's a straight close-cell EVA foam. We've got some grip pattern actually molded into it. So you can run it against your skin. You can wear it with a knee sleeve or a knee brace, but it's going to absorb no moisture, so there's going to be no smell, no odor. You can just wash it out with a bit of warm soapy water, let it dry. Obviously, fewer guys do that, but it's going to be fine, no odor with that interior. The other thing we've changed, we used to have a pad that attached to the straps. Sometimes people would lose them, they'd move around, so we've added a strap tail actually to the main body of the liner now. So it's going to wrap around. It also helps the D-rings from moving if someone doesn't do up straps 1 and 2 tight enough. So all the straps are numbered for a reason. 1 is what locks it above the calf to stop the brace migrating, and 2, obviously at the bottom of the hamstring, to give you the structural integrity through the hinge housing. But it's also a newer, smaller hinge housing, 5 times stronger ligament. So the simplicity of this brace is what makes it brilliant. 2 pieces, a synthetic ligament, a polymer hinge housing, 2 stainless steel screws that won't rust. So you can use it in the ocean, use it in the water, certainly get it wet trail riding, mountain biking. No stress about it rusting or corroding. Few moving parts compared to a lot of other braces.
To put it bluntly with you guys, it seems like simplicity is really one of the most forefront part of your development.
It is. Knee braces come from medical treatment braces. To your point, you know, there's some great medical brands out there, but they have 22 moving parts. The brace is designed for you, your orthopedic surgeon, your physiotherapist, to restrict your range of motion. We want to allow natural human motion when you're competing, when you're riding, whatever you're doing, but have protection on demand. POD stands for, as an acronym, protection on demand. So when you get into that red zone, when there's a chance catching your leg, hyperextending, dabbing from a jump, whatever it is, adventure, trail ride, motocross, that the dampening ligament, as well as you can add an insert, will slow your leg down from hyperextension, protect from lateral medial catches as well. So obviously protecting all 4 ligaments.
I think what's really cool, so if you actually look at the brace, like you said, we have this pre-preg carbon main frame, then you have your hinges and your cup protection area. Now the top and bottom of the brace are flexible, and I've heard people have different views on this because they see this like, oh, isn't the whole brace supposed to be rigid? But as you pointed out earlier, this part of the frame and the knee, you're supporting the knee as you're supposed Correct. To. The idea with keeping these flexible is to offer that range of fitment, because with most people, you know, whether they lose weight, gain weight, muscle mass, anything, the knee is a very stable component on its width, where the thigh and the calf size changes so radically from person to person.
Also when you're riding, I mean, you stand up, sit down, obviously you're in and out of the saddle, coming into the corners, getting ready to seat, bounce, or jump. Your muscles are expanding and contracting. If so you have a solid material top and bottom, now it's going to be pinching as you're moving around. And to your point, if you put weight on or lose weight. The other thing is, if you have a very violent crash, the force actually gets dissipated through the chassis into a softer material, and it's going to alleviate some of that force from going into your bones, into your skeletal system. So over the 10 years, we've been selling hundreds of thousands of braces, and this is the fourth generation premium pod brace. We've just listened to the market, our pro riders, biomechanical engineers, physicians, and again, we just keep trying to offer a better, lighter, stronger solution.
I think, you know, your guys' previous product has always been for the frame section itself, very light, very mobile, and easy to work with. I think, and it was probably what you heard as a complaint or a negative, was the previous patella cup for you guys. Like you mentioned, you had two sleeve sections, but you had a cup that was really offset from the brace. And as a lot of motocross pants have gone away from the giant accordion materials that allowed all this open area when the knee would flex, they've now gone to tighter stretch materials, but when they stretch, they're kind of pulling the cup in. And where you guys had that floating cup before, it was causing some material and size issues. So this is kind of the main
feature. Yeah, there was a little bit of snagging. Here. So you're correct. The philosophy now, and also for trail riding, you've got a CE certified protector down low here. So if you're kneeling down, working on changing a tire, getting something out of a hydration pack, or just out on the trails, you've got a much more comfortable instrument one-to-one, also for frontal impacts. The top is actually a softer nylon for handlebar strikes, but the two together, as you mentioned, they take up far less volume in the pants. So performance fabrics are actually starting to stretch, not that accordion. So whether you're running premium pants from any manufacturer, you've got a lot more room through the front of the knee now, and the pant liner will glide and slide, whether it's a full three-quarter or just a hung liner, over that knee protection. And trust me, we worked on so many of these with our motocross hard enduro riders. I mean, we rapid prototyped so many different options. So this is what we felt was the best balance for impacts, but also comfort, but, you know, obviously moving around on the bike as well.
I think off-road wise, what's interesting, you said you guys got a lot of guys in hard enduro, like Ty Blazusiak's one of your main athletes. And I've done more off-road racing. Moto, you have a lot more opportunity between motos to literally yank the gear off, reposition stuff. Duro guy is going to be in the saddle, you know, and offer 4, 5, 6 hours, some days all day. Like you said, from the way a trail rider bends out, it comes down to you guys not just focusing this as a motocross brace. You've given the real range, made it really comfortable for the dude that might be on an adventure bike all day.
100% correct. And you think about the weight too. Like, I love adventure bikes. If I ride an 1190 KTM, my panniers, soft bags, all the gear in my jacket, hydration pack, if I lose the front end in a sand wash or if it's greasy, I'm putting all this weight of the bike and my obviously own weight through your leg, through your knee. So we find trail riders, dual sport riders, adventure riders, people think it's just for the racer, but the reality is a soft tissue damage like a blown out knee, 6 to 12 months to recover from, and it probably will never actually get to 100%. I'd much rather break a bone than have a soft tissue damage. So honestly, boots, helmets, and knee braces should be a critical part of everyone's riding arsenal if you want to get back to work, obviously healthy on Monday.
Yeah, I think it's usually, because I'm guilty of it. If I ride a big adventure bike, like if I know we're going to do some really aggressive riding, I've got a brace on.
Yes.
But I've run into a situation, okay, we're doing more of a touring ride. I'm ditching the braces. Yeah. They're heavy, they're big, like some other brands. So like you said though, but you don't think of the low speed, putting around on a 600 pound bike that you could step off, catch the foot. Like there's definitely a lot of damage that can be done.
It's that twist, it's that slippery, you know, tree root. It's a slippery creek crossing, a wet stone, a bit of mud. That's when actually we find a lot of ligament injuries can occur. So it is designed for all, obviously, off-road motorcycles, for snow bikes, but can be used in mountain bikes and other activities as we spoke about before.
So, like I said, this is the latest version of the K8. Correct. It is replacing a prior version. So this is the all new updated one for you guys. What's the pricing? What's the availability? How do people get their hands on these?
So the price is $799.95 for a pair. There's four sizes, importantly. It's a very intimate fit, so small, medium, large, extra large. They'll be available in dealers early September 2018, exclusively distributed in America through Western Power Sports. So we're excited to get them out in the market and get feedback from customers out there wearing them as well.
Cool. Thank you very much, sir.
Appreciate the opportunity. Thank you.